What is up, guys? Zach Scott here, playing Plants vs. Zombies Heroes, and this is the $4.99 Lawn of Doom bundle, which basically gives you early access to the jack-o'-lantern. And today, in today's episode, we're going to be showcasing this bundle, mostly the jack-o'-lantern, though, and see how it works, because this is the first time that I will have ever used this card. So this is really a cool thing. This came out with the worldwide release of Plants vs. Zombies Heroes, and so I'm pretty excited about it. You know, now there's a way for you to get seemingly exclusive cards, and I thought to myself, you know, once I opened up one pack, I thought to myself, well, how can I go ahead and get more of these? I guess for now, I don't know what they have planned in the future, but for now, the only way to get that card is to buy the packs, the $4.99 packs. And so, you know, I'm doing it for you guys. You cannot craft them. Like, if you take a look here, iceberg lettuce, okay, fine. You can craft, recycle them. You cannot craft or recycle these. So, and maybe you wouldn't want to recycle them unless you had extras, but you simply cannot craft any of these, for now at least. So the jack-o'-lantern at the moment is exclusive only through those $4.99 packs. And you guys have been so supportive of this series, way over a million views on the first episode. So I thought, hey, let's go ahead and get four of them, make a deck out of them from scratch, and then we will, you know, try to go in. I don't know if rank mode is going to work yet, but we're going to try to go in and you know, make a splash with these cards. So it's a solar plant, and so my solar characters, we have, you know, we could use Chomper. I kind of want to use Chomper for this, because I kind of like the idea of growth with strike through, and but we'll see. I'm gonna go ahead and make a deck from scratch. We're gonna go through this process. This is a process that I should have done initially, but basically what I want to do, I want to go through and just see. You can only have four per deck. That's why they have the recycle all, which gets rid of all of your excess and trades them in for sparks. But for this, let's see, where is... I think I do want four of these. I know that sounds kind of absurd, probably, but I'm going to go ahead and get four of those. And then I'm going to go with other things, just kind of two on two, see how this works for us. I don't really know. This guy might be cool. This guy could be cool. Doubled mint, of course, two of those. Maybe two sweet potatoes to move things around, two of these. Two tacos, yes. Two of these, two of these. Holy goodness, this is gonna be good, isn't it? Maybe two of these, maybe two Bananasaurus Rexes. I'm kind of getting down to it though, and then that's all. Now, I don't have any super awesome thing that costs a lot of money, so I don't know. I hope this is a balanced enough deck. I kind of maybe don't want four of them now that I think about it, but maybe I do. This is a really tough decision for me. So let's see. Let's really think about it. If this doesn't work, I can always reformulate the deck. That's another thing that I always kind of forget about. I don't really have any top of the line stuff here, but if we really do rock, like, we'll try this out. This will be Chomp. I'm gonna rename this Chompzilla, and then Jack. How do you do O's? Check O. lantern. Oh, so we'll just call it Jack. I don't have that much space. All right, Chomzilla Jack. Okay, sure. okay. All right, I'm back. This is the Chompzilla Jack-o'-lantern deck that I've made now. I've made a few tweaks. I think this looks good. What we're going to do is we're going to take this into just a regular... we're going to try this plant mission, this finale here, because typically, you know, when I test out decks, I do like to have kind of a nice, like, safe space, so to speak, to test them out. This boss fight's kind of interesting. We'll see how it works. And really, I just want to be able to play it and see how it plays before actually going into any sort of competitive mode. This seems like an okay start, to be honest. This seems like an alright start, so let's see what happens here. We start with the drawing two cards, which I think is going to be what I should do. Now we each have, he has 10 health, and, okay, his deck is all Eureka, and he has plus 10 health. Do I not have any sort of bonuses? I guess not. Anyway, this might be a little tough for me, but I'm going to go ahead and draw these two cards. So open up, draw two cards. I have a lot of cheap cards, so I imagine I'll be able to play soon. He's going to play that. He's at a deficit, though. He's going to have a lot of randomness. All right, so nothing happens the first round. This next round, though, I think we're gonna have a lot of interesting moments here, especially if I can play this right off the bat and do two damage, I guess. He's gonna keep getting random cards. Let's see what we got. Is he doing it again? He's doing it again! Again, so this is the final matchup in single player, by the way. I don't know that I'll win this, but the main thing is I want to test it. I want to be in a good position to test, so... Oof. Yeah, that's amphibious. That sure is amphibious, isn't it? So, of course, what I want to do is I want to do everything I can to kind of make this happen. This guy's going to get canceled out. Yeah, I don't know. Might as well play it here, right? Or not here, per se, but here. I guess. I don't know. Just protect him. Let's see what happens. He's going to hit me with the amphibious, which will be 2 damage. I'm going to have an extra... yeah, there we go. Extra sun. Perfect. With a 4-4 there... You know, I'm not really sure what's going to be the best situation for me, but with a 4-4 there... I'm going to boost up my flower a little bit. We got a pretty extensive thing in that lane then. I'm going to deal 4 damage. Alright, there we go. Again, hit for 2 in the amphibious lane. Alright, now I have a lot to play. All zombies get plus 2. That's not cool. That's actually really, really tough to deal with. I'm going to go ahead and... Alright, so I don't like the fact that this guy has plus 2 there. I should have played it differently. Should I have not? I guess I should have. Oh well. We'll put one there. Okay, he's gonna get 3 random cards. I'm gonna basically take care of the middle. Cancel it out. I'm gonna deal 4 damage to him. He's gonna deal 4 damage to me. Something's up with his block meter. I don't quite understand. It's always been like this, though. Alright. So this is intriguing, for sure. He's gonna make up a whole bunch of zombies. So let's see what I need to do. Though the backup dancer in that lane is pretty good, I guess. So what I want to do, I'm going to go ahead and play this. Here we go. Now this is very, very well thought out, I think. Let's deal with this. My flower is going to be gone, but that's okay. I still haven't got the jack-o'-lantern that I want. I have 4 of them in the deck, but I don't have the jack-o'-lantern right now. All right. Oh, he blocked finally. All right, so let's see what needs to happen. This is gonna be tough. Oh, anti-hero, is that gonna attack me right now? Darn it. I think, gosh, I blocked it. Destroy a zombie with the lowest health. That's the amphibious guy. Absolutely, that's the amphibious guy. Goodbye. Okay, took care of that nuisance. I got a taco, which can heal. This guy grows. Still don't have the jack-o'-lantern, which is what I really want. So I have a couple things I can do here. I can give him the +1/+1, then do a bonus attack, which I think is gonna be very, very crucial. Also put this guy here. I think this is a great round. He's gonna have to get 3 random cards, and then I'm gonna do 10 damage to him. Again, I was really wanting to showcase a jack-o'-lantern, so if that doesn't happen, then I'm gonna feel a little annoyed. But, you know, I have 4 in the deck. I should definitely get one. I mean, I'm going to win next round. He might block it. Okay. Actually, that's a really... It's an even better way to do it. Let's go ahead and give this guy +3/+3. I'm going to go ahead and heal 4, draw a card. Maybe I'll get him. All right. This is crazy. He's going to block the next hit, I'm sure. He needs to, at least. I really wanted to play that one card. It just hasn't happened yet. Destroyed. He's gonna block this. He didn't block that. Okay, weird. Okay. I did not get to showcase what I wanted to showcase. But this seems to be a pretty powerful deck. I kind of want to go back in and try again. I got a quest complete. Nice. 10 gems for that Chompzilla there. Heals Chompzilla or plans for 5. I can maybe pull that off too. But again, the whole goal of me going in there was to play that card. So let's see what happens. If I go back in. It's one of those things where it's hard to know if you're going to be able to do what you want to do. All of these are 3, so all those are kind of too expensive. Gosh, and I still have all very expensive stuff. So let's see what we got. So I got the draw 2 cards, of course, which I can play right off the bat. All right, still don't have them. All right, let's see what needs to happen. Because I really just want to showcase the Jack-O-Lantern, and I mean, that's the card I have the most of in this. There we go, finally. Okay, there we go. Excellent, I'm happy about that, I really am. Put in the strike-through guy. Make this work. You know, and I might play, I don't know if I'm gonna play him immediately. We'll see what happens. The cool thing is that the coolest part about this is strike-through, and when he hurts the zombie hero, which he will do with strike-through, he gets +1, so it's like he grows +1 each turn. The strike through that grows +1 each turn. That's a brilliant move. All right, so let's see what happens. Okay, that's fine. I get the benefit of being able to just play him without worrying too much. He might have a trick, but I don't know. Okay, he made the space cadet, but he made it in the other lane, which is great. All right, whoa, he blocked. Darn it, man. Oh, well, that's fine. We'll figure it out. I got a mallet for him, you know? If he tries to plant anything in front of him. Oof. Yeah. Darn. Oof. Alright, that's definitely there. Go ahead and destroy the amphibious one, I guess. Alright, this pirate man. He's pretty big. He's there. He got him randomly, of course. I don't know if that guy exists as is. I think he's usually in a barrel. There we go, and I get to grow. Look at that, he's a 3-3 with strike through now. Perfect. All right, let's see what happens. Another Amphibious, okay. Ooh, okay, that's pretty cool. Not sure what to do. I mean, I know what I want to do. I want to give this guy a +3, +3. All right, sure, let's do that. We'll let him draw cards, because it doesn't really matter too much. They're all going to be that card, I guess. I'm excited about the 6 strike through. Which now will be a 7. Nice block. Zombie with the lowest health. Probably definitely the amphibious one. It's the thing that concerns me the most, to be real. All right, now, I think we're on target. Oh my God, another amphibious though. Oh, it's 6? You've gotta be joking, kidding me. There's no way I can deal with that. Oh my God, I'm just gonna have to heal. I'm gonna have to heal 4, draw a card. Holy cow. Well, we got another one of those, that's cool. Man, the 6 is scary. I'm really scared about that 6. I'll have tacos again. Man, the 6. How do I get him out of there? Get him out of there. I don't remember if I brought sweet potatoes in this deck. I don't think I did. That is awful. Okay. All right. Let's do what we got to do. Oh my God. He might win this one simply because I can't if this happens like this. Okay. Gosh. Heal 4, draw a card. That 6 is just terrible. All right. 2 damage to me. I'm so dead. I am so dead. There's just no way. I might be able to block something, but whatever. I'm so dead. I'm not gonna block the 6 though. All right, I'll do that. One more hit like that and I'm dead. So I clearly have to work on this strike through business. Yeah, if I get hurt, I'm so dead. Let's see what happens. He's doing the 3 random cards. He must have a really awesome trick. I don't know what he has, but if he gets rid of that 9 there, even with the commando, I mean, I'm still doing the 9 damage unless he blocks it. So I gotta really, really hope to hit him. Yes. All right. So yeah, the jack-o'-lantern is pretty powerful with that strike through. I'm just saying. I think we all can tell that that jack-o'-lantern is a really, really powerful card. Now, I kind of want to bring this into a casual match. I think I'm ready for a casual match. I don't know for sure, but we could try. I hope that I can actually, you know, be our hero, right? Yes, I will. So let's go ahead and battle, but we're going to do a casual match, and I'm going to bring in my Chompzilla Jack deck, hopefully. Now, hopefully we have some people to go up against. If not, then I'll just wait until I do have a matchup. You know, this game is still pretty brand new. And, you know, a lot of people are playing as plants because that's the default. So once someone has a zombie deck who's ready to go against me, I will be RB. All right, I wasn't able to get the casual match going, but I've been challenged by someone. So let's go ahead and play. I'll try it with this deck. This person's new, so, you know, it's gonna be, I don't know if it's gonna be easy or hard, I don't know. They could just have a new account and still be a really skilled player. It's just a really, really tough thing to know. I'm gonna shuffle out nothing. I'll leave it all the same. Let's see what we can do here. I got to draw 2 cards, which is a good opening to be real. So let's draw them out. Oh man, never mind. I'm gonna have to block that really quick. So I'm glad I have something to block that. So there we go. We're gonna cancel each other out. So there we go. I don't want him to do 4 damage to me the first round. Next up, let's see. All right. I could definitely block. Let's block this guy because this guy's going to be, you know, this guy actually has a power. So we're going to take him out. All right. And then I'm going to try to show some restraint depending on what happens. You know, we could definitely, so he has a lot of little guys. Not really sure how to handle so many of them right now, but I do kind of want to, well, one thing I want to do is I want to kind of just, you know, put this guy out here, I guess, block one of them. We'll see what happens. They're both going to be injured in a way. He doesn't have any tricks ready to play. All right, so I'm gonna have like a 2-1 there and then a 2-1 here who can do another attack. All right, it's 18 to 18. Let's see how I can keep my current plants on the board. Oof, that's a tough one. That's a real tough one to do. I mean, I could give this guy +3/+3, but then he'll still be at a pretty severe disadvantage. Not much I can do with him, to be honest. +2/+2. There we go. I'll do that. I'll beef him up just enough to take him out, and then I'll draw 2 cards. Oh, and I got both of them to be jack-o'-lanterns. That's really cool. He doesn't have enough brains to do any sort of tricks, so this is going to be good for me. So basically, I have two ones on the board right now. Here's a 1-1, which I blocked. Heal your hero and all plants for 4. I'm gonna save that for later, for if I need it. All right, so let's see. Does this guy have team up? No, he doesn't. Okay, that's fine. So let's see what he's gonna do. He might have a pretty big card to play. I don't know. All right, so let's see what he's gonna do. Ugh, okay, yikes. All right. So, you know, what I wanna do, I wanna play this here. And then, yeah, I mean, I don't really wanna do anything at the moment. Gravestone with deadly. So yeah, that's gonna be something to worry about. Especially if he's there. So he doesn't have any brains left. So I guess all the brains were on the gravestone. I guess the gravestones don't use brains until the gravestones actually open up. All right. So I do a strike through. He now becomes a 3-2, which is really good. So now let's see what happens. I have a lot of cards. I've been kind of going at this really easy. He might have, that might be another deadly guy, I don't know. Let's open up with, let's put this here. And I don't know about him, but I know that, I could definitely, there we go. I can leave that 2-2 there. Yeah, he's deadly. I'm glad I didn't beef him up, but, because he's gonna die. Okay, he does a bonus attack. That's pretty good. I don't know if I would... I would have done maybe a bonus attack on the other guy is what I would have done. So I got hit for 2. He blocked that one. Not sure what he has planned. Move a zombie. Does a bonus... That's actually really good. He's going to move it. I don't know where he's going to move it. I would probably move it to the left. Yep. Nice plan. So both of my jack-o'-lanterns are now dead. Simply because, you know, that's just how it works. That's just how it is. Okay. So one thing now that I can think to do. I mean, I can start countering these deadly guys. Try to maintain as much control as I can. But I don't know what he's going to do. If he has a trick up his sleeve, I really don't know what he's going to do. So yeah, he has some sort of trick, I think. I'm gonna play this. And then, you know, I might try to keep him on the board rather than him dying. And let's leave it at that. Let's see what happens. I don't know what his trick is. A 3-5 is just okay. Okay, he does a bonus attack, okay. So that's gonna do 2 damage to me. I'm gonna block the next hit though, so that's good. Excellent. Destroy a zombie with the lowest health. That's always gonna be him, I guess. All right, got him out of there. Both of my jack-o'-lanterns were easily taken care of, but now I have another one here. But I only have, he might block the next hit. That's one thing to really consider. He might block the next hit, but I don't know. Just trying to keep my guys kind of under control. That is pretty good. But again, if I'm here just to win, then this, I don't care too much about him, but I could really beef him up just to make sure he stays alive, just in case. There we go. This looks good. And then next round, if I somehow make it to next round, I will. Okay, yeah. Oh, nice, nice. He's destroying that. Never mind. Never mind. So I will take the 4 damage. Okay, he did not block it. So there we go. Fantastic. Fantastic round. All right, now, that was awesome. Again, so Jack-O-Lantern is, of course, you know, any strike-through plant is susceptible to deadly. So you gotta really watch out for that. All right, I've been challenged again by another new player, which I'm glad there are new players, and eventually you guys are gonna be able to just, you know, grow and grow and get ranked up and ranked up. Let's try it again. This seems like a decent enough deck for me to use. So let's see if we can get this going on. And so far, you know, I think what's happened is there's been just a flood of players. Because it's a super popular game, it's featured on the App Store. There's been a flood of new players, and so we have a lot of level one people. And you know, in a way, that's good. But at the same time, it's been kind of hard to find casual matches and even ranked matches because I think there's just so many players who are not at my level at the moment. So playing these little challenges with you guys has been a real blessing. So let's go ahead and see what we can do to open it up. If he's not going to do much of anything, you know, my question is always going to be, you know, do I play this, let him grow? Do I draw two cards? I don't know. Looks like next round I'm definitely going to get to play that one. But I'm always curious, you know, does he have something to counter that? Does he have a trick to counter that right now, or will that plant be allowed to grow? So there we go. He's going to grow. It's going to be a 2-2 next round. I can't really play anything except for drawing cards, so... You know, he takes it out or not. I don't know. I can't really do anything to help. Yep, I can't do anything. Okay, draw two cards. Oh, you know what? Why did I skip my turn? I could have had a one. Yep, I did have a one. Darn it. Oh, he has to move a plant. That's hilarious. All right, I'm happy enough with that. So I do have sweet potatoes in this deck. I was wondering about it because the past few matches, you know, I've had instances in which I'm like, man, I wish I had a sweet potato. But... I do have a sweet potato. That guy's gonna grow now, which is hilarious to me. So now I get to really be picky about what I do. Armored, you know, he's not going to be able to hurt me. So I kind of got to decide, you know, what do I want to do? I can always heal that plant later. I can also start kind of setting up for a big play. After combat here, he does a bonus attack. That could be good. Let's see what happens. If he buffs him up with that one, he might have a trick that can buff him or hurt me or anything. But let's see what happens. So weird that he gave him +2/+2. I know it's gonna hurt me, but I mean, at the same time, this guy ends up surviving. Oh, he blocked it. Darn. Do I get to do another attack? I do. Excellent. So now that's a 3-1. A 4-2, rather. All right. Okay, yeah. This is tough. It's kind of, you know, what do I want to do the most? He has a lot of strong guys out here. I cannot underestimate this. I'm gonna block this guy. All right. There we go. I think this is a good opening move. I get to block a lot of stuff. I think the armor guy is gonna take me out though. All zombies get +2, yikes. That's actually really good. Man, this is good. For him, not for me. This is good for him. Yep, okay, wow. He has a lot of guys on here that I simply do not like him having right now. This is definitely alarming, but I'm gonna put this here. I'm gonna put the Bananasaurus Rex right behind him. He has some sort of crazy plan, I bet. I don't know. Let's see what happens. Okay. That plant is gone. He's no longer growing. At the same time, look at what's happened, though. I get to hit him again. He's gone. This guy's gone. Darn, man. He's got a lot of destruction going on. And I get hit by this. He's blocked twice. I haven't blocked at all. So this is, okay. I hate the chicken. It's kind of funny. It's like, who do I want to destroy the most? Probably the chicken, just being real. And then, you know, heal four, draw a card. I don't have any other things to play. Doubled mint is great, but man, is he gonna let me play it? Here's the thing. This can get out of hand really, really quick. We both have heals. I guess so. Got him. Okay. 14 to 13. Very down to the wire. I don't know what's gonna happen. I really don't. I'm gonna try to get a double mint out, and maybe a lane that he's not gonna have covered. But I really don't know what's behind that. So. Move a plant. My goodness, who's he gonna move? I would probably, I mean, geez, he's gonna probably wanna do five to me. Yep, wow. All right, double mint is gonna double though next turn. The five is devastating, obviously. 10 to 10. Goodness, oh God. Okay, yep, I can't do anything about this right now. This is not good. Draw two cards. So yeah, this is about all that I can do. Just to hope that he stays alive. Block this guy, please. Oh, move a plant. Darn it, who are you gonna move? Who are you gonna move? Oh man, okay. Move a plant. Who can move now? Oh man, I don't even know. Jeez. Okay. This is brutal. This is a good match. Oh boy. Okay, so he's now 10-4. Draw two cards. Please give me something great. I don't know. Nope, nothing great out of that. That's for sure. I probably played it in the wrong order. Let's just go with this. I don't know what kind of trick he has, but if he gets rid of double mint, I'm done, but he didn't. So we're basically clearing the board again. Too bad double mint is gone. He still has his armored guy there. Holy cow. So I don't have anything as great as, you know, oh, the amphibious is gonna ruin me. Oh no. Yeah, the amphibious is really bad for me right now. Just saying, cause it's, oh man, okay. Oh boy. I don't like that amphibious being there. Neither one of us has extra cards at this point, so. This is gonna be bad. Bad news. This is a really tough match. This is a really close one. Ah, he blocked his last block. I still have two blocks left. Oh God. Okay, well, okay, that's fine. Goodness. I'm gonna take five damage. Please block something. Or don't. It's okay. Ugh. Okay. The only thing that I can really do, and again, this isn't much, is put this guy here. I'm probably gonna get, I hope to block the three from the amphibious. I don't know if I will though. He doesn't have any more blocks left. I still have a bunch. By a bunch, I mean I have two blocks left. Okay, great. All zombies on the ground get minus one. There's only one that can have that happen to them. So I'll take it. Yeah, this is tough. This is tough stuff. He's only gonna have one card. Oh my god, no! Oh, brutal. I can't believe it. I'm so dead. I am so dead. I'm so dead. Oh my god. I can't believe it. I don't think I have any top tier stuff in my deck. Yep, I'm so dead. Oh my god. Yep, I'm dead. Because what's gonna happen? Yeah, I'm so dead. He won the game with that. I can't believe it. Super lucky. Well, also skilled. He's skilled. Let's not fool ourselves. I'm dead. I am so dead. Oh well. This was a good round. This was a good round. I'm so dead. It was a good matchup. And see, this is what I mean by don't write off level one players, because they could be people with new accounts. They could be people who have watched the gameplay for so long. They could be people who have just simply played the game already for so long, but haven't, you know, made an account yet. You know, so I think so. But that was, anyway, he was a really good player. So anyway, congratulations, man. Oh man. So yeah, I think I've done a lot to showcase what the jack-o'-lantern is all about. I don't know, you know, if I should. I don't know if I should alter this deck at all. I kind of feel like if I did alter the deck, what I would do is I would probably put in some more late game stuff in here. You know, I don't really like. You know, I don't really like this guy. I would probably remove him, put in some more later game stuff, such as. Well, any sort of plant destruction would also be good. I have healing built in. You know, but if I want some more later game stuff, I could definitely put in one of these guys. Like, that guy would be great late game. I could put in, you know, this is what? This is, just destroy a zombie. Maybe I would add one of these. I don't know. This would be a slightly better deck, I think. But again, you know, this wasn't a super well thought out deck for me. I just wanted to really showcase a jack-o'-lantern. I think it's a pretty, it's an okay, it's, I would rate it as an average deck. I don't know if anyone else wants to play. But man, that was tough. All right, I've challenged this person to a battle. This will be my final battle for this video. And you know, we're gonna see how this works. This is with my slightly updated deck. I'm gonna go ahead and cycle that out. That's probably too expensive right now. Maybe that's even too expensive. So let's go with this. Let's see what we can do. And my card is to destroy a zombie with the lowest health, which could be useful depending on what he plays. I would not use it on that guy. I would play there. And then let's see what we can do with a little bok choy right there. Bonk choy, sorry. He's now a 2-1. And then, okay, it's that when you play a trick. So if I were to destroy a zombie with the lowest health right now, you know, I would probably, do I want to do that? Do I want to save the bok choy? I don't know that I do. I don't think it's going to be worth it in the long run, but what will be worth it is to kind of cancel this guy out, maybe. Just to at least block it. Alright. So let's go ahead and this will be my last round. I played a lot today. Let's see. Here we go. Hit him. So we both cancel each other out in the left lane, which is good because that guy is a little bit more powerful than just a regular guy. Man, I don't know what that is. But I'm going to give that plant a little boost. He's now a 4-4. Oh, gravestone. I'm so glad that I didn't. Okay. So that mushroom's dead, of course. And this is due to devour a zombie with the lowest health, which would not be that guy. So let's see what I want to do. He gets plus one when you play a trick. I kind of want to just, I want to devour him. I don't know what kind of trick he might have planned. But I don't want him growing stronger. But if he does play a trick, my guy is going to grow. He's going to get plus one, so he draws two cards. My guy gets is now a 5/5. So there we go. See, we each had people who grew when zombies played tricks. I don't even think I've gotten to the jack-o'-lantern this time. All right, he blocked that. Let's see what he's gonna do. Move a zombie. Oh, that's. If he moves it to the left, then that's good. That's good. Yep. That's brutal. Because that guy is now dead because that was a deadly. All right. So if we think about what we want to do here, you know, I kind of want to keep this guy alive. So I think what I want to do is play this, and then make him 3/3. That way I'll be able to deal 5 damage. Not just this round, but next round as well, unless he gets taken out. He doesn't have any brains for tricks this round, so I know it's safe. I will, at the cost, take 6 damage, but I might block some of this stuff, so that's kind of the benefit, is that I anticipated a block. All zombies on the ground get minus 1. That will take out the imp, which should lead me to a victory. Nope, he blocked that one. And I don't know what kind of card he has available, but all zombies get deadly draw a card, okay. So he has to do something. I don't have to do nothing. Let's see. I'm gonna block this guy. I'm gonna beef up this guy. I might win it right here, unless he has a really awesome trick. It really just depends, because I have... Okay, draw 2 cards, okay. This is another round where I haven't really got to play a jack-o'-lantern, but... Oh, man. Okay, yeah. Bonus attack from him. I would have maybe done it... I mean... Okay, yeah, I'm gonna win anyway. Unless he somehow miracle blocks. Nope. Okay, great! Well, guys, thank you for watching. Be sure to come back next time for more. I'll see you then. I think I did a good job showcasing the brand new jack-o'-lantern. And I had a lot of fun with it. So come back next time for more. I'll see you then. Goodbye.